Hello everyone, I hope all you are doing very good in your life. Today in this video we are going to see the dual nature of a matter, or nothing but we used to see that de Broglie hypothesis. Okay, before we are going to see the concepts, I highly recommend you to go to the previous video by clicking the I button here and see how the Planck's law is introduced in a quantum mechanics, how energy is equal to n into h nu. These are the basic concept you must know for to understand next concept. So don't miss that. In I button as well as in a description box I will give the link. First see that and then we'll continue with dual nature of matter, de Broglie wavelength and so on. Okay, and on your request I have given PDF notes link in a description box. Don't forget to download it, and before that share with your friends and subscribe to my channel. So let's start the video. Okay, now as we already know, in a PUC we came to know that light has a dual nature, like it may behave as a particle and sometimes it may behave as a wave, right? So to prove that, we have conducted so many experiments. For a particle nature we conducted many experiments, and for a wave nature also we have conducted so many experiments. Like one of the experiment we can say the Young's double slit experiment for a wave nature, and so many experiment which is related to prove light has a wave nature, and so many scientists has been tried to explain light has a particle nature. But ultimately what we said, light may behave both. That's why we call it as dual nature of light. Dual nature of light. Similarly, here we are saying dual nature of matter. Dual nature of matter. Let us see what kind of matter is this. Matter. Whenever we are saying matter, that means here we are talking about micro level particle, nothing but we are talking about electron, proton and neutron. So these are the matters. Okay, and these are, for example, let us take an electron. Okay, and whenever we draw a molecule, for example this is a nucleus. Okay, surrounding to this we used to draw the orbitals. In different orbitals we used to draw the electron which is revolving around the nucleus. Okay, when I showing like this, that means I am intentionally showing the exact position of the particle of an electron. Okay, so here we are showing electron position. Now that means this matter is behaving as a particle. Okay, this matter behaving as a particle. But according to de Broglie, he conducted or he saw so many experiments, like in the case of Compton effect, where electron behave as a particle, at the same time in the case of photoelectric effect electron behave as a wave nature. So that's why we said electron has dual nature. If electron has a dual nature, then like microparticles like proton, neutron also has a dual nature. If these three things have a dual nature, then we can say a matter also have a dual nature. That's why we name it as dual nature of matter. Dual nature of matter. I hope you got to know why we called dual nature of matter. Okay, now onwards, whenever I saw or whenever you are trying to draw a molecule, inside a molecule in center there is a nucleus. Surrounding to this there is an orbital. Okay, so surrounding to this there is an orbital, because in this diagram we can clearly say this is electron which is showing as a particle. Now we have to show same diagram, in the same molecular diagram we have to show electron as behaving as a wave. Okay, now in this diagram electron is behaving in the sense it's moving like a wave. That's why we call it as dual nature of matter. And this explanation is given by de Broglie, and the hypothesis word means he imagined the things, because obviously electron is the smallest particle where we can't see that. So that's why he imagined, by seeing some experiment, light has a particle nature as well as wave nature. So that's why we named de Broglie hypothesis. And when we said particle nature of an electron, then we can easily calculate the mass of the particle, velocity of the particle, moment of the particle, momentum of the particle, energy of the particle. And at the same time, when we said electron has a wave nature, at the same time we can calculate the frequency of the electron, wavelength of the electron, phase of the wave of velocity, amplitude and intensity. All these things we can calculate it, or we can calculate, and we can say particle nature is associated with mass, velocity, momentum, energy, and wave nature is associated with frequency, wavelength, phase of velocity, amplitude and intensity. With this we came to know what is the dual nature of matter, or de Broglie hypothesis. In VTU exam we can expect 2 marks definition for a dual nature of matter or de Broglie hypothesis. That's it. In this concept you can expect only 2 marks definition. Okay, so let us see the next concept, that is de Broglie wavelength. Let us see what in previously we said matter which is behaving as a wave and also behave as a particle. Now we, for supporting to that, we need to give one equation which says lambda is equals to h by momentum, or m into v. Lambda is associating with wave nature, and mass into velocity is associated with particle nature, and h is the Planck's constant. In a single equation we said we covered two important things. One is wave nature as well as particle nature. So how we got this equation, let us see. Initially we came to know that according to Planck's quantum theory, we have an energy equation for a photon, that is E is equals to h nu, where nu is equals to c by lambda. C is the velocity of light, lambda is the wavelength, c divided by lambda. So that's why E is equals to h nu is nothing but hc by lambda, which we have taken here. Now, as according to Einstein mass energy equivalence, very famous equation where it says E is equals to mc square. Here also we are talking about energy, and here also we said energy. So both energy are similar, so that's why we can write it as mc square is equals to hc by lambda. Now we can cancel the common term on both sides, c get cancelled. Then as I said, we are talking about wave nature, so that's why we can write by just altering it, lambda is equals to h by m into c. Lambda is equals to h by m into c. Now here m is the mass of the electron, okay, m is the mass of the electron. We can take any example like proton, neutron, electron. In here, to understand, we will take a mass of the electron. Now c is the velocity of light. Velocity of light, as I said, light has a particle nature as well as wave nature. So according to this, we have to say, when we are talking about particle, when light is moving and it has a particle nature, we can calculate the velocity. So instead of using c, we can write lambda is equals to h by m into v. Lambda is equals to h by m into v, and m into v is nothing but momentum equation. Momentum is equals to m into v, so substitute here h by p. So ultimately we can say lambda is equals to h by p. This is the equation we got, which explains about wave nature as well as particle nature. I hope you got to know what I tried to explain here. Okay, we got an equation for wavelength that explains wave nature of a particle. And h is the Planck's constant. We can say 6.625 into 10 to the minus 34 joule per second. So this is the Planck's constant, and this equation in your VTU exam, to arrive this equation, this part comes under 4 marks. With the definition of de Broglie hypothesis or dual nature of matter, de Broglie hypothesis or dual nature of matter, 4 plus 2, it may come for 6 marks. I hope you got to know. And similarly, next concept, we need to see the relation between de Broglie hypothesis or de Broglie wavelength and kinetic energy. So as we already know that what is de Broglie wavelength, that is lambda is equals to h by p, okay, and let us see the kinetic energy of what, of electron, the kinetic energy of electron. So electron means this has a charge, that is negative charge, and it is continuously under motion in a orbit. So we can write energy of an electron is nothing but charge of the electron into potential, electric potential, that is V. We can write it as half mv square, because it is comes under kinetic motion, because electron is continuously moving around the nucleus. Now half mv square, just rearrange by multiplying, energy is equals to half m square v square by m, multiplying both side, numerator and denominator, by m, then m square v square by m. So now we know that what is the equation for momentum. P is equals to m into v. Here m square v square, that means momentum square, that is p square. Write down E is equals to p square by 2m. This is the equation for energy. Now just rearrange it. Momentum is equals to moment p square is equals to 2m into E, right? 2m into E, nothing but if I remove this square, then p is equals to under root 2m E. So mass of the electron, energy of the electron, that if we under root 2m E, if we calculated, we will get momentum of the electron. And where is that? P is equals to lambda is equals to h by p. So we can write lambda is equals to h by, substitute, instead of writing p, we can write under root 2m E. Okay, and instead of this direct energy, if energy is given directly, then we can use this formula. Other than that, we can write h by under root 2m E V. V is the voltage potential, electric potential. E is the charge of the electron. Sometimes he may give, especially this part or this formula is used while solving the problems. So he used to say, calculate the de Broglie wavelength for a given volt, for a given voltage or given energy. If energy is given or voltage is given, then use, if voltage is given, use this formula. If energy is given, use this formula to calculate lambda. So you can expect 4 marks problem from this concept. I hope you got to know what I tried to explain in this video. If you like this video, please like it and subscribe it, and don't forget to share with your friends. With this, let's wrap up the video. Thank you.